Amen. 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 Sing it over. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Come on, in God's name, once more unto your fathers. Good Lord, how bright and goodly shines the moon. I say it is the moon.
I know it is the moon.
Why, then you lie. It is the blessed sun.
Then God be blessed. It is the blessed sun. But sun it is not when you say it is not. And the moon changes even as your mind. What you will have it named, even that it is. And so it shall be so for Catherine.
Forward! Forward!
Hi, welcome to Mimi's Place. And today we're going to dig deeper into how to live life subjectively. When you live life subjectively, you are an Israelite. Israel means one who walks with God. Okay? And Proverb 31 tells us how to do this. If you read it and you're still in objective land, then you're going to see it as a physical male act like this, physical female act like that. But that's not what it means. So let's dig in a little deeper, shall we? Yeah. I really love this proverb. It's the very last proverb. And when I decoded the proverbs on the Patreon site, it was, I had done 30. God works in mysterious ways. I didn't do number 31. So this is a patron request, and she requested a video because she's not in the layer of the tier at Patreon that gets the Bible decoded blogs. So I agreed to do that, and then I realized she could get the blogs, and I couldn't find it. You know, I was going to refer to it for the video, and there was none. And so I was like, wow, I need to decode this. So I decoded it, and it's just a beautiful proverb. It is absolutely beautiful. And it tells you, it doesn't matter if you're a male or a female or whatever you identify with. None of that matters, okay? This is talking about consciousness and the creative force. And they are represented as male and female. And it tells you how to be an Israelite, how to walk with God. Think like this. Okay? So we're going to go through it now. In the first, at the beginning, at the top, is the teachings of King Lemuel. I'm probably torturing that. His mother. The words of Lemuel, king of Massa, which his mother taught him. Lemuel means devoted to God. And Massa means to lift up, to raise up, to bear, to carry, to take away, as in it is forgotten. So this is one who walks with God, okay? He's devoted to God, and he lifts up others, and he bears or carries away their burdens, and he takes them away, and it's forgotten. What, my son? What, son of my womb? What, son of my vows? Give not your strength to women, your ways to those who destroy kings. It is not for kings, O Lemuel. It is not for kings to drink wine, or for rulers to desire strong drink, lest they drink and forget what has been decreed, and pervert the rights of the afflicted. Give strong drink to him who is perishing, and wine to those in bitter distress. Let them drink and forget their poverty, and remember their misery no more. Open your mouth for the dumb, for the rights of all who are left desolate. Open your mouth. Judge righteously. Maintain the rights of the poor and needy. This is telling you what you should be thinking consciously and holding on to like a rock. Okay. These are the things you hold in your consciousness. The child of my womb, you know, this is you. And Lemuel is speaking to himself. This is what his God in his heart, his imagination told him. Okay? Do not give your love to the physical world, to the objective world, to the outside world. Don't give your deeds to those who destroy authority. It is not for authority to go within to God and imagine. It is not for rulers to desire to drink and go within to God, lest they forget what they have said and pervert the rights of all the enslaved. Okay. It's not for them to go into their imaginations. They just don't do it. Okay? Their authority. And they have to stay on the objective side. But so, it's not for them to do it. You give strong drink to the dying, the zombies. You know, you imagine for them. You teach them. And you give wine to those in distress. You know, you imagine for those who are distressed. And you share this information. You let them drink, okay? Drink in their imagination. Let them forget that they're sick and that they're now well, that they're no longer poor, they're wealthy. You know, let them use their imaginations and learn. Open your mouth for release of their pain. You do it for them. You do it for them. You raise up others. You bear their burdens, okay? Let them drink and forget their poverty and remember their pain no more. You know, help them learn how, or you carry their burden for them and take it away. Open your mouth for the release of their pain and suffering. Forgive them, you know, release them. And perverts, they are dumb. They don't know to speak is to receive. They don't know these laws of mine. They don't believe in them. They don't, you know, it's a bunch of foo-foo to them. Okay? They're busy in objective land. So you are walking the road less traveled. Good intentions pave the road to hell. And that road is well traveled. You're going down the road that's less traveled. You're going to look at life subjectively. You're going to help others. You understand this is one. And you hold that in your consciousness like a rock. You know this is all the story. You know this is all imagination. You know this is all God. It's dream. It's spirit. It's whatever you want to think. But it's one. It's one consciousness. And it's God. It's God. It's all God. All of it. Even the rocks. It's all God. So raise others up. Err on the side of love and maintain the rights of all through the love of God. Okay, they're all God. You see them that way. We're all one. Okay, and that's what the male is told. Okay, and the male represents the consciousness. This is what you hold in your consciousness. Okay. You don't destroy authority. You go within. You carry the burdens of those who are being hurt. You raise them up when they don't know. And you share the information when they do want to know. And when you see people that are sick or hurt or poor or whatever, you raise them up. You bless everyone. Especially the ones who are helping you walk your road. You know? And bringing understanding. Because you asked. And so they're presenting to you that all these truths, all this information, they're everywhere, you know, and pick one that resonates with you, and that's going to work. You know, but you hold these things in your consciousness like Peter the rock. Nothing can move you. And then it moves into the creative side. You know, ode to a capable wife. A good wife who can find, she is far more precious than jewels. The heart of her husband trusts in her, and he will have no lack of gain. She does him good and not harm all the days of her life. She seeks wool and flax and works with willing hands. She is like the ships of the merchant. She brings her food from afar. She rises while it is yet night and provides food for her household and tasks for her maidens. She considers a field and buys it. With the fruit of her hands, she plants a vineyard. She girds her loins with strength and makes her arms strong. Behind every good man is a good woman. Who can find a good wife? This is talking about your imagination. You can find one who imagines good things for everyone. The wife, the female, represents the creative, imaginative force. Who can find a good wife who only sees good? You know, who thinks great things about everyone and everybody, you know, especially your partner, you know. How hard is that? She's more precious than jewels. You know, that's harder to find than a pearl in the wild. You know, it's like, grab her. You know, she seeks the best and works it willingly. You know, I got it. She walks with God. Is how hard is it to find a good woman, one who walks with God? It's hard, because most people are living in an objective land, and they're judging, and they're maligning everyone, including their husbands, wives, partners, whatever, your special persons, you know, your significant others, you're maligning them. You know, and other people that you deal with, people that you have to deal with, authority, bosses, you know, this kind of thing. So it's talking about how hard it is to find someone, you know, on one layer that walks with God, but it's really talking to yourself about, you know, this is how you need to think. Like this woman, okay? She always imagines good for all. She sees everyone as good all of her life, all the days of her life. She seeks the best and works it well. They're all the best. I forgive them all, they're all the best. You know, she is like the ships of merchants who bring her food from around the world. You know, I'm a ship of merchant. I'm going to, you know, bring it to me. We'll spread it out. We'll take it out. We'll spread it out across the world. I got enough love for everybody. There's plenty for all. She rises while it's still dark. And she imagines for her family and household. She gets up and prays. She prays for others. And she always has a good word for everyone. Okay? She's planting a vineyard. She's planting all these good thoughts, good words, good deeds. They're all coming out of her. She's one with God. And she is strong in her resolve. That means she's strong in her resolve to walk subjectively. It means you walk subjectively. I'm going to look through the subjective lens and not the objective lens. Okay? Everyone is just like me. I'm applying the golden rule to everyone. Everyone. No exceptions. Without distinction. No. Doesn't matter what your picadillos are. That's okay to have dislikes and likes. It's not okay to take it too far. You don't judge it. You know, somebody else out there loves it. And that's good enough. Okay? It's not for me to judge. Bless their heart. Love you. God's with me now. And you move on. Be a good human being. That's what this proverb is about. Then it goes on, she perceives that her merchandise is profitable. You know, she perceives that her life and everyone around her, everyone she's aware of, is profitable. Her lamp never goes out. Okay? It doesn't go out at night. It's always shining. She puts her hands to the distaff and her hands hold the spindle. She's weaving. She's weaving. Okay? She's weaving this beautiful life. And her hands hold the spindle. She opens her hand to the poor and reaches out her hands to the needy. She's not afraid of snow for her household. She's helping. She's raising people up. Here, here. No, you're not. You're not really like that. You're like this. No, you're not really like that. You're like this. Okay? I know that. No, no, no. That's ignorant. Nobody thinks like that. And she's always working it. She's always weaving. And so she's not afraid of snow for her household. For all her household are clothed in scarlet. You know? She's not afraid of what's going to come from God. Snow. Why? Because everybody in her household is dressed in scarlet. They're living the life. They're walking with God. She makes herself coverings. Her clothing is fine linen and purple. She's making her world be perfect and beautiful. She's pulling it together in love. Red, blue, together is purple. And the finest of fabrics that come from us, from nature, is linen. It's one of the best. Right up there with silk. You know, so she's doing the best. Okay. She makes linen garments and sells them. She delivers girdles to the merchant. She's doing this for others. Her husband, her family, you know, her lovers, her friends, or whatever, her world. She's doing it for others, and she sells them. Okay? She sells them and she's teaching. I have something for you. You have something for me. It's a win-win for all. Okay? Her husband is known in the gates when he sits among the elders of the land. You know, your consciousness is known at the gates of heaven. Okay? At the gates. When you go within, oh, we know. Here he is. Here she is. You know, you're well known at the gate. And people listen to you. Because most of the time you don't talk. You're listening because you're walking the road less traveled. You're living the subjective life. So strength and dignity are her clothing, and she laughs at the time to come. She's confident, okay? She's confident. She's strong. She's dignified. She loves herself. God's in her. She knows that, and it's wonderful. You know, this is how we should look at it. Imaginatively, subjectively, look at life subjectively. You know, all are wonderful, all are God. Okay, so she laughs at the time to come. She laughs at adversity. Okay, she knows she somehow thought that. She opens her mouth with wisdom, and the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. When she opens her mouth to speak, she walks with God. She talks for God. It's God coming out of her mouth. Okay? This is what he has to say. Wisdom. Okay? Wisdom comes from God. And the teaching of kindness is on her tongue. Love everyone. Find joy in life and in all the things you do. And you will love it. It's a great life to live when you live subjectively. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. She looks well to the ways of her household. She's going about the daily business, you know, and she's thinking well of everyone. She's cleaning her home. She's doing her thing, you know, and your thing doesn't have to be cleaning your house. but she's keeping her mind clean, is what it means. Your mind is your house. So she's looking well to the ways of her household. She's thinking well of everyone in the household. She's lifting them up if someone's out of a job. She's imagining they have that job. You know, this is the ways of her household. And she does not eat the bread of idleness. She doesn't sit around going, oh no, what are we going to do? Joe doesn't have a job. You know, it's that kind of thing. She looks well to the ways of her household and does not eat the bread of idleness. Her children rise up and call her blessed. Her husband also, and he praises her. All the people around you, in your home, and everywhere, bless you because you're blessing them. And they only have good things to say about you. They praise you because you're always praising them. Okay? You're praising God. And you're praising the one in all. Their hearts. And you see them that way. Okay? This is sincere praise. And he praises her. Many women have done excellently, but you surpass them all. You know, he just can't help himself. She's always loving on it all, and all benefit from that. Charm is deceitful, and beauty is vain. Charm and beauty, you know, worrying about it, if you are beautiful or not, you know, and charming or not, and you know, those things, and are seeing it objectively. So when you see things objectively, that's vain, okay? But a woman who fears the Lord is to be praised. But a woman, and the word fear here is just the way the Greeks translated it. They didn't have a way of expressing it. It means love. They had three other meanings for love, okay? And this one word got them going because it could go either way. So when you see life objectively, which is how most people reading the Bible, you know, it's leading them. So when they see it objectively, they read it this way. But once you really start to dig in deeper into these laws and dig into this book, you come to realize it means love. And in the Hebrew translations, it's both. Okay, so it's understanding that a woman who loves the Lord is to be praised. She's always loved with God. She's always praising everyone. You know, she sees the good in all. You can't shake her. There's no way. You know, you will never convince me that Joe's a jerk. Okay, so just stop it. He's a wonderful man. You know, he's a good man, and you're never, yes, he's grumpy sometimes, but you know what? That's just Joe. He still has a heart of gold, and I love him. You know, she refuses to see his grumpiness as a bad thing or anything else, except he is God, and that's just his personality, and it's all okay. You know, give her the fruit of her hands, and let her works praise her in the gates. You know. And she gets the fruit of her labor, you know. She's praising God. She's walking with God. And God's given her everything that the objective world struggles to get. And she's just being the best, you know, imaginative, creative power she can be. She's using that power beautifully, and they walk together. And this is a person who knows, okay? This is, if you see it on one level, it's about a man and a woman and how to think, you know, partners, whatever. This is how you think about each other. But that's not what it really means, okay? If you want to be illuminated and dig in a little deeper, what it means is these are your two sides. And one side, the conscious side, is devoted to God, and you need to recognize that what you hold in your consciousness comes to be true. Okay? You pull it out of your purse, hold it there for a few minutes, put it back. Pull it out of your purse, hold it there for a few minutes, put it back. This is how the law works. And then it gets so heavy, it goes down to the heart. Once it hits the heart, God gives it to me. Okay, that's it. It presents itself. It's the big review. Okay. So, you know, this is a person who knows that and is doing that. Not just for himself. In fact, not for himself. For everyone else. Because he knows he's taken care of. It's all good. It's all good. You know, I don't care how it happens. I know I'm all taken. It's all taken care of. All is well. I walk with God. We're busy. We're looking at all this great stuff, you know, that came out of him. And seeing how it all represents him and how he's so cute. So I hope this helps. It's a really great proverb on how you should be looking at life and how you should be thinking with your imagination and your consciousness. This is how you become Israel, okay? An Israelite. You are one who walks with God. So walking with God is cool. You'll really, really like it. Give it a chance. Give it a try. Can't hurt. You know? If you're already following LOA, you're headed there anyway, baby. You know, so this is the beauty of the Bible. It's your number one LOA handbook, you know, as we call it now. And it's got the 12 laws of mind in there and tells you all about yourself and, you know, who you are. And how to be. And depending on what layer you're in, determines how you perceive it and what messages you get out of it. But there's deeper messages in it, and we all instinctively know this. That's why we love that Da Vinci Code stuff and getting into symbols and stuff, because that is God's an invisible being. He has to show himself to you as life. And all the aspects of life, all these forms. You know, he's everywhere. So I hope this helps. Blessings to you. And thank you. Thank you for being you.
Come, Rowan, unable worms. Come. My mind hath been as big as one of yours. My heart is great, my reason happy more to bandy word for word and frown for frown. But now I see our lances are but straws. Come, and place your hands below your husband's foot, in token of which duty, if he please. My hand is ready. May it do him ease.
Why, there's a wench. Come on and kiss me, Kate.
Amen. 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 Sing it over. Amen. 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 See the baby. Manger
Amen.
On Christmas morning.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
See him in the temple.
Amen.
Talking with the elders.
Amen.
Who marvel at his wisdom.
Amen. Amen.
Down at the Jordan.
Amen.
Where John was baptizing.
Amen.
And saving all sinners.
Amen.
See him at the seaside, talking with the fishermen, and making them disciples.